at making a Newton color wheel. Now, for that, we need a couple of things that should be pretty easy to find. We need a bowl or some sort of item to trace for a circle, cardboard paper, regular paper, scissors, glue or tape, some crayons, colored pencils, markers, a wooden skewer, and a ruler. Now, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to use our bowl to trace a circle onto our paper. Go ahead and just use one of my crayons for that. So trace the circle, and then trace the same circle onto the cardboard paper. Then I'm going to go ahead and cut out those circles. Now, if I take my paper circle and give it a bit of a fold in one direction, pinch the middle, and then fold it in the other direction, and pinch that middle together. Where those two folds overlap, that is the middle of my circle. Now I'm going to go ahead and use my ruler to draw four lines that pass through the middle of the circle. And you want to draw them so they are about the same distance apart. Like we're cutting up a pie. All right, there we go. And now I'm going to color in each of my pieces of the Newton color wheel pie. One I will leave blank, and I'll do the rest the color of the rainbow. So I'll do one red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, and violet. Now I'm going to go ahead and color those in. And there we are, the beginning of my Newton color wheel. Now the next thing we need to do is take this colored portion of the color wheel and glue it onto the cardboard paper to give it a bit more sturdiness. So I'll go ahead and do that. Take those together, give it a little bit of time to dry, and once it's dried, you're going to take your wooden skewer and poke it through just in the center there of your Newton color wheel where they all touch one another, all the colors touch. Be careful doing this part, the skewers can be sharp, and give it a bit of a wiggle around in there. You want your circle to be able to move freely. All right, now this is our Newton color wheel, but we've come to the cool part to see what we can do with it. So what we're going to do is give this wheel a spin, and we're going to observe what happens when we give it a spin. Now, if we spin this fast enough, we should see those rainbow colors appearing a whitish color. And this happens because white light that we see from the sun or from most light bulbs is actually made of all the colors of light. And that's why when we combine all these colors together, we get white.